My name is James Powers. It's P-O-W-E-R-S. The Division of State Police.
And how long have you been employed by the State Police?
Approximately 10 years.
And what is your current duty position with the State Police?
I work in Troop A in the Seacoast and Rockingham County as a patrol officer and canine handler.
And in that position, what are your roles and responsibilities?
I conduct patrol, enforce criminal and motor vehicle laws of the state of New Hampshire.
And beyond that, what specific types of roles do you play as a trooper?
I'm also a canine handler while on patrol.
How long have you been a canine handler?
7 years now.
Let me direct your attention to the date of April 20th, 2022. Were you working on that day?
I was, yes.
And what were your duties on that day?
I was, that was during a patrol shift, a regular duty. On Interstate 95.
And do you recall that day of the week being a Wednesday?
I do, yes.
Now, did you receive any information regarding a missing persons report on that day?
I did, yes, from the canine unit commander advised me of a missing person case and a canine request in Concord.
Okay, can you describe the details of what that report was?
I was initially just given information that there was two missing adult subjects in Concord, and a canine search was to be conducted. So we requested a my assistance with another canine handler at that location.
Do you recall about what time of day you received that notice?
That was about 8 o'clock at night.
And did you end up traveling to Concord?
I did, yes.
What happened when you arrived?
Upon arrival there at that location, Sergeant Ingham of the canine unit and Trooper Kevin Devlin, who was the canine handler on scene, had conducted a map survey of the area, given the information they had, and advised me that they would be conducting a search.
Okay. And, did you have any information regarding the identity of these individuals that were missing?
At the time, I was told there was just two adult male. One adult male and an adult female missing from the address from the previous Monday on April 18th.
And beyond consulting an overhead map of the area, did you do anything else prior to beginning a search?
Not at that time, no.
Okay. Were you by yourself when you conducted the search?
I was not, no.
Okay. Who was with you?
Trooper Devlin.
And can you describe what type of search you conducted with Trooper Devlin?
Trooper Devlin handles a search and rescue hound. I was assisting him as a backup during that search.
Okay. And when you say search and rescue with a hound, is this a canine that's specifically trained for search and rescue?
Search and rescue, yes, for missing or lost people is what their specialty is.
Yes.
type of search was being conducted?
At the time, it was just a hasty search of the area.
And can you describe what a hasty search is?
We just started off, we really had no start point. We were just looking for a missing subject at that time. So we just kind of started off just quick, like I said, took an overview of the map and just find areas of probability that a missing person could be.
Identification as states exhibit 75. Mm-hmm. You recognize this?
Yes, if you pick it up higher. Yes.
What is it?
This is an overview map of the Concord area of 393 and the location of the Altonwoods Drive address.
Does this appear to be
picking you up?
Just maybe
I'm sorry.
A bit closer to the microphone. And I think during
yes.
Overding as well.
Yes. Does this appear to be a fair and accurate representation of the area?
Yes.
And does this include the area that you searched on the evening of April 20th?
It does, yes.
Permission to admit and to publish this exhibit to the members of the jury, Your Honor?
Any objection? Oh, do you want to take? Yeah, of course.
I don't think so, but yeah. I didn't see which one. No objection.
Okay. 75 is the full exhibit.
Thank you.
And it can be published if you want to. Yeah.
Thank you.
Maybe just tilt it. I just want to make sure the defense is able to see it as well.
Yeah. I will walk around.
That's absolutely okay.
Is that okay?
That's fine. That's fine.
With the court's permission, may the witness step off.
Of course. Yes.
I was just using that the map is could you describe for the members of the jury where you initially responded to and where you conducted your hasty search?
On this map, Altonwoods Drive apartment complex is located in this area right here. I'm not sure exactly where the specific address is. We moved through Altonwoods Drive into this. This is a open area or open field with overhead power lines right here. Trooper Devlin determined this area to be the first search area with this. You can see this triangle of wooded area. That was the initial search, primary search area.
And you're referring to the area just what appears to be just east or northeast of the Altonwoods complex?
Correct, this area here.
Okay, and that was the initial area of your search?
Yes.
Okay. What did you find in the course of your search?
So the search started in this light area here, just an open dirt clearing. Once you moved into that wooded hill, that wood line here, not long after entering that wood line, we came across a male subject in a tent there.
Okay, and can you describe what this male subject looked like?
It was just a male subject in the tent. He never exited the tent, other than just his head. Just a young male, his 20s to 30s.
Okay, call his race?
It was a white male.
Okay. And can you describe what your encounter with him was like?
We initially identified ourselves while we were in that wood line. And again, we were looking for missing persons at that time. We asked if he had seen anybody. He said he had not. He identified himself. And then we contacted the Concord Police Department just to inform them of the person we found in the tent there.
Okay. When you say he identified himself, what information did he provide you?
He just provided his name and called it Arthur Kelly.
He provided you the name Arthur Kelly. Did he provide you with any additional information?
The only thing I wrote, he provided that he got there earlier in the day when he set up his tent.
Did he indicate if he had seen or heard anything else in the course of his time there?
He told us that he didn't see anybody else in the woods since he had been there.
Okay. Can you describe what the tent site looked like when you encountered it?
It was just off the trail. While we were in here, it was a unimproved walking path or trail, and just that tent was, I would say, 5 to 7 yards off the trail. And it was the other thing of note that it was littered with red cans or bottles of the soft drink Mountain Dew.
What did you do after you encountered the individual that identified himself as Arthur Kelly?
Like I said, we informed Sergeant Lowell of the can that was back at the command post, back at Altman's Drive, and they called the police department of just this person that we found in the woods. And then told them where they could meet us so we could show them the nice location.
Okay, so you ended up following the encounter with this individual. You met with members of the Concord police?
We did, yes.
And what did you do with them?
We exited the woods back out to this clearing. We just met them and then escorted them back into the wood line where the tent was so we could speak to them.
Okay, so and were you present when they spoke with the man who identified himself as Arthur Kelly?
Briefly, we were, yes.
Okay, and about where were you located during that second encounter with the Concord police?
We were still on the path, but a little bit further away from the tent site.
Okay, were you able to hear any conversation?
No, nothing that we heard, no.
Okay, and what did you do following escorting the Concord police back to the man who identified himself as Arthur Kelly?
Well, they continued their conversation with them, and then Trooper Duggal and I continued on with our search of that area.
Okay, and where did you continue to search?
We continued just into this, this wooded area, of this triangle of Old Bottom Road, Portsmouth Street, just checking this whole wooded area.
Okay, and following a search of that area, did you search anywhere else?
Once we determined that area was clear, we didn't locate anybody. We did find a secondary search location, which we moved to the south side of Route 393. And there's, maybe time to see here, but there's all a wooded area right here that's just north of the apartment complex and south side of 393. So all in this area right here.
Okay. About how much longer did you search that evening?
There was probably another 45 minutes to an hour.
Okay. Following the remainder of the search that evening, did you have any further involvement in the investigation?
No, once we cleared this area here, that was terminated, and that was the end of my involvement for that night.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Powers. I don't have any additional questions for you about defense counsel.
Thank you.
Yes, I do. Thank you. You can have a seat.
Did you want to use the
my
diagram? Okay, absolutely.
Can you see okay?
I can see, yes.
Okay.
You,
the,
yes.
The map, not me.
Yes, some of it's cut off, but yes.
Okay. So my first general question is about the information that you are receiving in order to determine where to conduct the search. And you meet with several people?
Two people, yes.
And who are they?
Sergeant Gary Ingham, who's the commander of the K-9 unit, and Trooper First Class Kevin Devlin, who was the K-9 handler that night.
And his K-9 is Wyatt?
That's right.
Okay. And had you talked to anyone else, like the civilian witnesses or any other people involved in coordinating searches or anything?
I did not, no.
Okay. So if there was a coordination before you talked to Trooper Devlin or Ingham, it happened before you got there?
Yes.
Okay. So your understanding was that you want to search areas around Alton Woods?
That's right, yes.
And Alton Woods was the apartment complex where the Reeds lived, right?
Yes.
And you kept your search on the south side of 393, right?
It was, yes.
There was no information that you received that suggested you go on the north side. Is that right?
Correct.
Okay. And can you see where I'm pointing to?
Yes, now? I can. Yep.
I can move it
mm-hmm.
if you need. So for the jury, from the complex of Alton Woods, in that open area that you were talking about, there's a dirt road, right? That sort of intersects that open area.
Yes.
About in the middle.
Yep.
And then at the end of the dirt road, there's a not quite circle, but a bigger patch of gravel area.
A clearing, yep.
And that ended up being a staging area for other coordination of the search by the time you were done, right?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay. So they hadn't set up there by the time you were done?
Who's they?
Other Concord PD and the
lab? Not that I were, no.
Okay. So what you did was you, in advance, decided the wooded area on the other side of Alton Woods going down that dirt road, the wooded area, would be a good place to search.
Yes.
The dogs. Because other people can walk around and search, but that's a better fit for dogs than people being able to observe everything around.
Yes. Right?
And other people are out searching Alton Woods area and stuff like that.
Not that I'm aware of, no.
Okay. Do you know if any were out later?
That night? No.
Okay. So you decide this in advance. This looks to be a good area to search. And you walk down the dirt road to that gravelly clearing, and then you go into the woods. And pretty quickly, you run into that tent, right?
Correct.
And right away, you have contact with the occupant of the tent.
Mm-hmm.
And
just say yes or no. I understood what you want, but just if you don't mind saying yes or no. Great, thanks.
And he gave the name Arthur Kelly.
Yes.
At your request.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, you said, who are you?
Yes.
And then you conveyed that information to Concord PD.
We did, yes.
And Concord PD was already there, but not with you and Trooper Devlin and the dog.
Yeah, they were not with us at that time, yes.
Okay. So after that wooded area, you searched, again, another wooded area that was essentially between 393 and the apartments in that complex.
Yes.
Or condos. Okay. And was that it?
That was all,
you?
Yes.
Were you part of the line search the next day?
I was not, no.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Any further?
No, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Members of the jury, we will take our morning break right now, about a 10 to 15 minute break, then we'll resume with testimony in this case. So, Trooper, if you wouldn't mind staying there for a moment while the jury goes back, and then any objection to the trooper being excused? Okay, great. Then you'll be excused.
Thank you.
And you can just leave them on the chairs. Yeah, that'd be fine.